Okay, it's about quarter to eight, or quarter to nine, Montana time, on a Saturday. I'm heading up to the Lewis and Clark Caverns today to do a sculpting demonstration. I don't know how it's going to work out because it's calling for thunder showers today, lightning and thunder. So I don't know how many people will actually come up to the Lewis and Clark Caverns, but anyway, I'm going to go pick up Julie Birch. She's going to talk to people while I'm sculpting and help me sell artwork, hopefully. Not that I'm expecting any sales because it is not a gallery. So I'm going to go pick her up right now, and I'll pick it up at the Caverns. All right.
You on?
I'm on. Hi, Robin. Come here. Come here.
I'm just going to introduce you.
I think you have to bend down. Hi, this is Robin. She invited me up here. And then Julie, she's not going to get in front of the camera because she doesn't like to get photographed. Anyway, I'm set up to do Lewis and Clark. I don't know how long it's going to take me to do it. I don't know if I can do it today. But can't know until you try. And what I did was I actually figured out the head size of Lewis and Clark. And I printed out the size here so that I can take my calipers and take the measurements from here and transfer it onto the clay. So that's how you work from a clay or make a portrait of somebody that's dead. You try to find as much as you can on them and try to get their proportion. And I got my light set up on my camera tripod actually, which works pretty good. All right, I'm going to just get busy, and I don't know how much I'm going to video, but I'll get as much as I can.
Once I stood at the foot of a great high mountain that I wanted so much to climb. And on top of this mountain was a beautiful fountain that flows with the waters of life. I fell down on my knees at the foot of I cried, oh Lord, what must I do? I want to climb this mountain. I want to drink from this fountain that flows so clear to my view.
Recently did
on top of this mountain saying started climbing upwards, taking one step at a time. The higher I got, the harder I mountain with me.
I'm doing Lewis now. I'm not cranky. Three times.
I've only seen you cranky. Maybe twice.
All right, now let's get serious here. I'm never serious. Life is just too serious to be serious.
Sorry.
Where's your light, dude? I've got a lighter on. I gotta move his mouth back, so I'm gonna try to suck in it. See how he looks like he's sucked in. Cut his mouth off, and I cut off about maybe that much clay. Dropped it back, and now it's at the right angle. Yeah.
That's why I think Clark's more handsome than Lewis. Lewis looks a little bit.
He looks a little dainty.
I was gonna say.
That sounds funny when you even say that, Dave. Dainty. Say it again.
Look how deep.
And David, you said you've been doing this 40 years?
Yeah, almost 50.
Oh, these made out today.
Mm-hmm. Pretty cool. Don't touch.
You are welcome.
All right. This is Robin.
I bring cameras.
How the hell did you guys find me anyway? How'd you get me up here?
You found us.
Did I? Was that it?
I sent an email to the Anniston Arts Association, and you answered it.
Oh, that's what I did. Okay.
She answered.
I know.
Anyway, they put out a display from made from China. Made in China. Anyway, this is a display of Lewis Clark stuff.
Except for the ones that came from Taiwan.
And then this is this is Ruth. She was part of a play I was at in the early part of this century. Julie, she's packing up for me. And this is Lewis and Clark. Let me get the light back on.
Oh.
What, you jerk? Anyway, that's Lewis and Clark. No, it's fine.
It's right here.
And, you know, I didn't finish them up. I just did a couple hours on each one from scratch. And so as far as I got today, I'm going to leave these here. Julie's plugging me in. Okay. Now you can see them. So anyway, that's Lewis and Clark. And did those in 2 hours each. And then I have my display of items here. On display here. Here we go. Now you can see it. That's the display as it's set up here. So that's going to be it for tonight. We're going to pack up now and head out. You'll see me.